I got two EV6s behind me. As you can see, this one needs a power, and I try my best to drain the battery out on this one, but it was just really, really difficult. I did some research, and when the battery goes like dead zero on this EV6, the previous versions, they actually needed a jump start with those typical batteries that we see inside the car before the car gets ready to charge, because that actually starts the car. But that's not the case with the EV6 cars that are built from the EGMP, which this car is. If you have another EGMP car, that could be EV6, IONIQ 5, and GV60, and other Hyundai Motor Group EV cars to come, such as IONIQ 6, when you have one of those cars ready, or probably you could ask somebody,
you gotta have this.
So this is the emergency charging kit, as you can see, and this will be where I will be connecting the V2L with, and this is the good AC charging port. So make sure you have a car that has the V2L. This is a must. So this thing, this little guy comes in super, super handy. So make sure you have this V2L outlet. Of course, this is the donor car. This is going to be giving the battery to my EV6. So just plug it in. And as soon as you do so, the car is going to recognize the V2L. Turn the power on, and you can see this green light lights up. Then this is, you know, the V2L is ready to go. So mostly it comes like that. So make sure you open this guy like that. Moment of truth, I'm going to be connecting this. And this is the emergency kit. And this came in early Hyundai EV car, because, you know, back in the time, there were many cases and there was not much of the infrastructure ready for the charging stations and whatnot. So these guys came together with the car as an accessory, but you don't get it no more. But plug it in. You see, this power lights up. So I'm inserting another video right now, where I showed you, I connected this to the actual power outlet on the wall. And so it's lighting up just exactly as it did on that case. So you see, there's another outlet here. Bring it all the way. It's nothing special, it's the same thing now. Open up the car that you are charging. And actually, I am low on the battery. I tried my best to drain the battery out on this one, but it was just quite impossible. Plug it in, wait some time for the car to recognize, and listen to it. There you go. I forgot to put the language into English, but then it said, you know, the charging has started. And let me show you inside so that the charging actually did start. So I am inside. There you go. It says the remaining time is 30 hours for 100%, and it's charging at 2.5 kilowatts. Literally, it's an emergency of the emergency, right? Let me set the language into English. Well, nothing special happens. So it says the remaining time is 30 hours, 16% charged, pushing out at 2.5 kilowatts. Let's go to the donor car and see what it's got to say. So as we can see, it's doing the work, it's charging actually. The donor car, it says, yep, so the V2L is currently up and running and it's at 2.5 kilowatt is the usage. So it's exactly saying what it's doing. And well, there are some of the power loss in terms of the cables, less of the efficiency when it comes to charging from a car to another. But again, it's better than nothing. It's for your emergency, right? So this has been the V2V, which is vehicle to vehicle. I mean, literally, you can see these two cars are running battery packs. You can share the battery, you can give the battery to wherever is needed. Currently, we're just used to using the car as the V2L, right? Plugging this into lights, hair blowers, other accessories of your need. So you can use this on your camping sites, connect it to other power sources, and have the media, have the music going on and whatnot. As you just saw, this can work as the V2V, and you can emergency charge your car and also help out a fellow EV owner if there is a dead car on the street by any chance. So next time you see one, keep in mind that your car comes with the V2L and you can use the V2V like that. All right, so that's it for today's video showing you about the V2V on top of the V2L right there. Big shout out to my friend Howard for allowing me to film his car using that as a power source and coming up with today's video. And don't forget to subscribe and like Cars in Korea if you did, and I'll see you in the next video.